Also, it's kind of like burning my eyes a little bit. I don't know why. Like, can you see? My eyes are getting a little watery. Bad, but in real, it just looks like someone like farted glitter on my face, on my eyes actually. So it's just like glittery. So this is how my face looks like. Hello everyone, and welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are doing good today. So in today's video, it's going to be a little bit different. Normally, usually, I recommend you guys amazing makeup, but in today's video, I'm going to show you guys why you should never get these makeup. All of these are very affordable, but yet they perform so bad. And I'm going to actually show you guys on my skin because you can see I have bare skin right now. I'm going to show you guys why exactly you shouldn't get any of these products. So without further ado, let's get started. Also, if you are someone who's new to my channel, thank you so much for clicking this video. If you like the vibe, if you like my content, you can hit the subscribe button because I post 4 days a week, so you get fresh new content every single week. So without further ado, let's get started. So I actually don't have a primer with me for today's video, but I don't have a primer that I dislike or I hate. So I have this Dazzler foundation. I got this a while ago and it's been sitting in my collection ever since. I really don't like this at all, and I'm going to show you guys why. So I'm taking a pump of this and I'm just going to put this all over my face. First of all, this has no coverage at all. I mean, it looks very, very patchy. It looks like the Purana Zamana type of foundation, you know, we used to use, our moms used to use. So it's something similar like that. So I'm just going to blend this obviously with my fingers. If I go in with a beauty blender, there will be nothing. So just blending in with my hands right here. So you can see that it is so patchy. Like, it is extremely, extremely patchy. It just sits on top of the skin. It looks really bad. I mean, I don't even know who is going to wear this foundation. I mean, this is just terrible, 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 terrible makeup. So yeah, just apply it like a face cream. You might think I'm not really blending it really well, but if it was a good foundation or BB cream, it would just blend into my skin so well. I'm just going to show you guys, bring the camera in closer a little bit so that you can see how it just sits on top of the skin. You see, it's like not sinking in with my skin. It's just sitting on top and it looks so, so bad. But yeah, this is how the foundation looks like. I mean, it's so bad, so patchy. I just need to throw this foundation out, you know. After making this video, it's going directly into my trash. So this is the foundation. Never get this. Also, it's kind of like burning my eyes a little bit. I don't know why. Like, can you see? My eyes are getting a little watery. I don't know why that's happening. So anyway, moving on to the concealer that I have, which is something that, again, I don't really like at all. This is the NY Bay. This is the foundation stick. Now, someone did compare this to the Nykaa foundation stick. So I was like, wow, this is going to be good because Nykaa foundation stick, I've heard that it was pretty good. I don't have the Nykaa foundation stick, but anyway, that's why I got this shade. And you can use this as a concealer, as a foundation too. But oh my God, I'll show you exactly why I don't like it. I mean, first of all, it's not really depositing any much like pigment on. And then the second thing is, it's very like a little, it's not emollient like I would want a concealer to be. Like, can you see? I'm just rubbing it all over my eyes and there is like almost like no pigment coming from this foundation stick. So it's like, I don't know what to say. It's like no use. There is no use of this concealer or foundation stick. So right now, as you can see, this is how it looks like. I'm going to blend this everything with my beauty blender so that at least it looks a little bit okay-ish. So this is my beauty blender and I will try to blend this in. So I'm just trying to blend the whole foundation in. I mean, it's still looking really, really bad. So what I'm actually doing with this beauty blender is just that I'm taking it off, maybe, you know, because I'm just like trying to blend it in, but it's not blending in at all. So this is as good as it's going to get, I think so. So now moving on to my contour situation or bronzer. I'm going to take this CAL palette right here. This is so bad. This is like a very thick type of consistency. You guys know I love the CAL primers they have. I love their lipsticks too. But this one, oh, I really don't like this at all. It's kind of a little very sticky type of a, you know, this has so much of stickiness to it, like, almost like a glue kind of a consistency. And this doesn't suit my skin tone also. Like, this is 02, but it still doesn't suit my skin tone. It has this weird smell to it. I mean, it just feels like a cheap makeup, you know. I like doing affordable makeup on this channel, you guys know that, but I don't like cheap quality makeup. There is a huge difference in affordable and cheap, but this one falls under the cheap kind of category, you know. It doesn't, there is like so much of less pigment to these things. So anyway, I'll just put this. Like, it doesn't look bad on camera, to be honest, but in real life, I feel like it always lifts my foundation. Obviously, today I'm wearing a really bad foundation, but still then, I really don't like it at all. It's like, it doesn't look natural on my skin. Every time I wear it, I'm like, no, this doesn't look natural at all. So, yeah, this is how it looks like. I mean, on camera, honestly, you cannot say anything, especially because I'm wearing really bad foundation, so it's like, you know. It cannot get worse than that. So now coming on to cheeks, I have the worst blush ever. So this is the Baked Blush by Palladio. I think that's how you pronounce the name. I was so much into this brand. When I saw their products on, you know, on the internet, I was like, oh my God, this brand looks so good, because they had such amazing products on their site. And it was like a mid-range kind of, the product's value was almost mid-range. Like, this blush was 400, 500, 600, around that price range. So I was super excited, but when I got, most of their products were such bad quality. So I'm just going to use this blush and I'm going to show you why I don't like it. First of all, this has a lot of shimmer in it, and I don't mind a little bit of that subtle shimmery blush, but this is like way too much. Like, this is, can you see, it just accentuated my texture pores. It's just going to show you guys skin texture that you thought you never had also. So this is how the blush looks like. So bad. Like, if you have extremely poreless, textureless skin, then maybe you can get this blush and it will act like a highlighter and a blush. But if you have even the slightest bit of skin texture, please do not get this. It's the worst blush I have in my collection, and I would urge you guys to stay away from these blushes. I know I did not put a blush on this side. I am going to, but first I'm going to talk about this highlighter. I'm going to put this highlighter on this side so that you can see how bad this highlighter is without the blush. So this is again the Palladio I Am Glowing Liquid Highlighter. So when I saw this on their website, I was like, oh my God, I really want to try this highlighter, because at that time I was compiling my favorite cream highlighters, and I really wanted to, you know, get a cream and liquid highlighter. And I got this and I was super excited, but everything looks so bad whenever I use this highlighter. I'm like, I'll just show you guys, and you can see that by yourself. Just a dot, that's it, right? Blending with the beauty blender. Okay. My face just has a lot of sparkles, that's it. Like, my face looks so bad right now. It's patchy, it's full of shimmer, glitter. I hate it so much. Now, I know that you cannot see the actual thing on the camera, so I'm going to show you guys with my phone camera how it looks like, so that it can capture how it looks in person. Sometimes the camera and the lighting, it kind of makes everything look good than in real life. So I'm just going to use my phone camera and show you guys the clip. Can you see how patchy this looks like? I mean, you see this, right? It's just sparkles, glitter sitting on my textured skin. And this is the blush side. Really, really bad. And you guys might think that I did not use these products really well, or I'm using the foundation, so that's why maybe it's looking patchy or something like that. I have tried all these products so many times on my face, and every time I use it, I'm like totally disappointed. So that is why I give up. I give up on all these products, you know. So the next we have here is this eyeshadow from Swiss Beauty. Now, this one was, you know, a shocker to me, because a lot of people love this eyeshadow. I really don't like it at all. I feel like it was very patchy. I tried to use this in so many different ways, but every time I use it, I'm like, I get like a very patchy kind of a finish. So yeah, this is how it looks like. I'm just going to blend the edges, because obviously I have to blend the edges now. So can you see how patchy this looks like? I mean, it's not the worst product I have in my collection, obviously, but it still isn't good. I love the Mars liquid eyeshadow so much more than this. That just is so easy to work with. I mean, a lot of people say that you have to use a brush, you have to use your fingers with this and all of that, but for me, if something doesn't really work that well with one go, I really don't want to use this. I really don't want to spend my time with makeup, you know. I just want makeup to be fun, and I don't have to sit there and blend the eyeshadow and wonder which brush to use, what finger to use, how to strategically use this. I don't want any of that. So yeah, this is how my eyelids are looking. On camera, this doesn't look that bad, but in real, it just looks like someone like farted glitter on my face, on my eyes actually. So it's just like glittery. So now coming on to lips, I have this Specta. This is a lipstick, and this is in the shade Famous. Now this one, this brand, I really like their lipsticks, no doubt, but this one in particular, the shade Famous, it's not for me. On packaging it looks okay, but it is a very shimmery lipstick. It almost feels like a cream eyeshadow. So this as a lipstick, it doesn't look good at all. So I'm going to show you exactly why I don't like it. I look so good today. Extremely amazing, you know? So the last product we have here is this Mars Makeup Fix Up Spray. Now this is something I got from Amazon. You cannot get this on their Mars website. So what happened is, I just want to say a little bit about this spray, is that Mars actually doesn't carry this anymore. So Mars was a brand that had been around for a really long time, but their makeup was extremely like cheap quality before, but somehow they reformulated, revamped their whole packaging, the whole brand. So all the products now on Mars website are reformulated products, and they are amazing quality. I honestly cannot take myself seriously, you know, doing this makeup. I just cannot. So anyway, the products you see on Amazon that you cannot find on the Mars website are their older stock. So this is like an older stock from Mars Cosmetics. This is not a new stock. This is not their reformulated makeup. So I just wanted to put it out there, because I know I talk a lot about Mars Cosmetics being a really good affordable brand, but this is not from their revamped collection. This is the old stock that they had. So anyway, why I hate it is it has so much of glitter and so much of sparkle and so much of shimmer in it. I honestly do not need any more shimmer. My eyes are glitter, full of glitter. My cheeks is full of glitter and shimmer. My foundation is patchy. My lips look so disgusting right now, but still, for the sake of this video, we are just going to spray this all over. And not only does this have shimmer, this like squirts water on your face. So I'll show you what it does. Just all the water right here. It doesn't like spray it really evenly. So this is how my face looks like. How amazing do I look? So that was it for today's video. I mean, the foundation and the setting spray takes the cake, you know. These two are the worst ever makeup on the internet that you can find. So that was it for today's video. I hope you at least enjoyed it, although it wasn't useful. I hope you guys at least enjoyed, you know, seeing me with a very disgusting face right here. Anyway, the foundation and the setting spray takes the cake, obviously, because I don't think so there is any makeup out there. I refuse to believe that there is any makeup that would look so terrible more than this. I just don't think there is. So anyway, I'll see you guys in my next video. Also, if you are new, I generally do a little bit better, you know, with makeup and stuff. So you can binge watch my other videos and see. And if you like the vibe, if you like the content, you can hit the subscribe button. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.